हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम यू ऑल वंस अगेन इन माय ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। आई पंकज चावला। इन टुडे लेक्चर वी फोकस ऑन इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ पीआईडी विद कंट्रोल सिस्टम। पीआईडी दैट इज प्रोपोर्शनल इंटीग्रल एंड डेरिवेटिव। यूज ऑफ पीआईडी विद कंट्रोल सिस्टम। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी वर डिस्कस्ड हाउ टू इवेलुएट स्टेप रेस्पॉन्स यूजिंग वन मेथड इन मैटलैब कोडिंग। And I already suggested that there are two methods to evaluate step response. So in this lecture, we will discuss another method to evaluate step response and then continue further. Let's start. So first, we have a quick review of previous class as we assume this as a typical example of control system for our study and then evaluate transfer function of it using standard formula of transfer function. Then we learn MATLAB coding on the concept of numerator and denominator coefficient of GSHS and use some command to evaluate transfer function and then finally use step command to obtain step response. For more detail of previous class, go to the link which is provided in description box. Now move toward learning of another method to evaluate transfer function of the system. First we discuss here, then try it on MATLAB platform to perform it. In this method, we use TF command first to initialize S variable so we can directly work in S term, no need of calculating coefficient as we do in previous method. Then use plant name variable to initialize value of GS and feed name variable for HS as shown. Then use feedback command to evaluate transfer function of complete system in different format as compared to previous method, that is feedback in small circle bracket plant into feed comma 1 and assign value in sys variable. So when we run it, we get value of transfer function as a value of sys variable. Now move towards a MATLAB platform to perform it. Once you open a MATLAB and a basic layout of MATLAB you get, then open a script file to work over here. First two line used to put comment, that is plant and feed used as a variable to represent GS and HS. Then use those three basic command as discussed in previous class also. Then use TF command as TF small circle bracket in a pair of single inverted comma S variable to initialize S value. Then assign value of GS and HS in plant and feed name variable as discussed. Then use feedback command to evaluate the transfer function of the system. Now simply run this file and you get output at command window as a value of sys variable, that is transfer function of the system, as same as we obtain in the last class also. Now use step command to evaluate step response of the system like this. Then just right click on a graph, you have a option of measuring parameter and you compare the value of these parameter from previous class and you observe that all values are remain same. So in this way, these are two methods as we discussed. I refer second one as it is easy and rest your choice. You can adopt any one of the method. Let's talk about PID, that is proportional, integral and derivative. It is used as a controller in closed loop control system. PID is explained with the help of a mathematical equation. But before going into mathematical calculation, let's build a foundation of it. And before that, we have to understand closed loop control system. So this is a typical closed loop control system in which we have a plant which we want to control. Here we have a controlled output as a output of plant, reference signal as an input of plant. Our problem is that how we generate reference signal so we get desired or control output. Firstly, we use feedback which continuously compared with reference signal to generate error signal, and according to that plant work and try to achieve desired output. That is the condition when error get zero. So our target is that we want error get zero. For this purpose we use controller before plant like this. A controller work in different form and help system to get this error zero in proper manner. Output of controller is known as a actuating signal. Today we talk about PID controller. So to understand the working of PID, we taken an example of AC, air conditioner, as a plant. In previous class, we take an example of fan. That one is open loop control system. There is also a logic behind it to take fan and AC as an example. Presently the weather is summer, so maybe you feel cool while talking about fan and AC. Hope you with me. So let's discuss the working of AC on aspect of PID controller. Once AC gets on, in AC there is a temperature sensor which continuously measure room temperature. Assume that room temperature presently is 28 degrees Celsius. Now we set desired temperature 20 degrees Celsius. So using feedback, it continuously compared with room temperature and according to that error signal generate. Firstly we discuss proportional controller. Basically it helps to achieve desired output fast. Let me explain. Initially we get magnitude of error signal 8. In this case it multiply by proportional constant Kp to generate actuating signal. If we assume Kp equal to 1, then according to that actuating signal become 8 second. It means desired goal achieved in 8 second. If Kp equal to 0.5, then actuating signal become 4 second. Goal achieved faster than previous case. In this way proportional controller help to achieve goal fast and vice versa depend on requirement. But in this case once goal achieved and error signal get zero, cooling function of AC gets off. But since output continuously compared with reference, so maybe again error generate within second and again controller work and achieve goal and so on. So in this way cooling function of AC gets off, gets on, gets off, gets on. It can't stable at operating point. This known as a steady state error. To reduce it we use integral controller along with the proportional, which helps to continue the operation at stable point. As its name is integral, so it is related to integration concept. It has a capability to store past information of the system and continuously integrate it to achieve goal and try to maintain across desired goal. But in this case now plant may get overshoot due to continuously integrate itself. So we use derivative controller along with them, which do not allow the system to overshoot. In this way this controller work to reduce the effect of integral controller after once system achieve goal. So PID controller work in that way. It try to achieve goal fast, maintain the system across a stable point, do not allow the system to overshoot. Basically PID work on each aspect, that is present, past and future value of the system with the help of proportional, integral and derivative concept respectively. Hope you enjoy the learning of such a beautiful concept of PID controller with the help of AC working. In next class we will discuss PID in MATLAB coding. I like to see you all again in my next class. Till stay tuned with us.
Hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon as we keep on posting informative content like this. You can also get certification from Tishitu Research Center if you finish minimum of 10 videos from the playlist. To get more information about this, connect to us at tishitu@gmail.com.